Hi, today we will be building a solar power USB charger using only two electronic components, the solar cell and the voltage regulator IC7805, which is a 5 volt DC voltage regulator. The panel I will be using is a 3 watt solar cell and which would produce very small amount of power. However, it can be still used to charge cell phones at a slow rate. The output of this panel is 8 volt with maximum current of up to 350 milliamps. Just before we proceed, let's try to understand what a 7805 regulator is. So 7805 voltage regulator is a DC voltage regulator and it has three IC pins. The first pin is the positive input, the second is the ground, and the third is the positive output voltage. There are two series of this voltage regulators. One is the 7-8, which gives us the positive regulated output, and the 7-9 series, which is a negative voltage series. Just to understand what a voltage regulator is, output of a full bridge rectifier or any rectifier is not always DC. In fact, it's never DC. It's always ripple pink DC. When we use a filter, these ripples in the DC output would be made or brought to a certain level where it can look like a constant DC voltage. With the frequency of the input lines being 50 Hz or 60 Hz, this doesn't impact most of the applications. However, there are certain applications which are voltage sensitive and we need a constant DC voltage. And if you have ever experienced, most of the time as the current increases, the voltage drops across the load. In order to avoid all this, we use a voltage regulator which gives a constant DC output irrespective of the current drawn by the circuit. Now, how we will be assembling this is a small circuit that I have done here. So this is the solar panel, which is a 3 watt solar cell with an output of 8 volt and 350 milliamps current. And as I will be getting a DC output from this solar panel, which I don't need to regulate further, but I need it to be constant at 5 volt. This 7805 series of ICs can have input voltage up to 12 volt and give a constant regulation of 5 volt. So I just need 5 volt constant output voltage and current say up to 500 milliamps. However, that is not possible using a 3 watt solar panel. So my current would be somewhere around again 300 milliamps at the output. So I will be using this 7805 IC in this configuration where the positive will go to the first pin, the positive of the solar panel. The negative of the solar panel will go to the second pin and it will be also connected to the load, that is to the USB charging socket. And the third pin of the IC regulator, which is the regulated 5 volt voltage, would go to the positive of the USB where we will be connecting the devices to charge. So before I begin with the circuit, I will also like to add some additional components. The female connector for USB port and a raw PCB, what we call as printed circuit board. So I need to prepare a layout and I have just made a blueprint of the layout with hand on a small paper. And this is the size of the actual layout that I'm going to make in order to fit into a small case that is already there behind this solar panel. So in fact, I have ordered all of this from various sites, but Amazon being the prime one for the solar panel and for the regulator IC. I have ordered this too from Amazon and this is from RC Circuits India. You can get all these components anywhere in a local hobby shop or any of the electronic shop nearby your house. To begin with, I would just first replicate this layout on the PCB, get the PCB ready, and then fit the circuit inside the solar panel. So my PCB is ready for etching. This is how we are going to do the etching. We are going to insert the PCB in ferrous chloride solution, which will take over the extra copper and keep the copper that is under the paint. So let's begin doing the etching. This is how the PCB looks after the etching is completed. The extra copper
which was exposed has disappeared in the ferrous chloride solution. This is the final piece of PCB after the paint has been taken out. Now we will go and proceed with drilling the holes for the components to be inserted into this PCB. So now we are going to drill the PCB using this mechanical spring control drill, and I am going to use a 1mm diameter drill bit, which is normally used for any standard component. So let's begin. Here I keep the drill bit on the point where I need to drill the hole. And this is where it starts drilling the holes on the PCB. And here we have the hole. Now let me finish drilling all the holes on this PCB. This is how the circuit looks after drilling all the holes. And now as it is ready, before I put down the components into this hole, I'm going to tan this copper layer with soldering metal so the components get easily soldered to this holes. Also there will be some oxide layer over these copper plates and the soldering wouldn't be perfect. Now that I have finished tanning up the PCB, I will start inserting the components into the PCB. And I'm going to solder them to the PCB. Now that I have finished soldering the components, my circuit is ready. I have connected the input wires to the output of the solar cell and the USB charging port. I will be inserting this circuit in this manner. Screw up the case and take it outside for testing. I have closed the case, but I see some gap in between this cover, so I am going to use insulation tapes to cover it. And that is just because my circuit has grown bigger than what I expected with the regulator IC going in. I just see that I don't cover up the USB hole. This is the place from where the USB socket is visible, and I will be connecting the charging port over here. And that's done completely, and this is how it is covered now. Okay, with the, I just need to see that I don't cover the USB, and it's done. So let's take outside for testing this. So this is our USB solar charger, and I will be charging an Android phone using this solar charger. So let me first connect the USB cable, the output of the solar panel. Now we have the IC regulator inside this case, which will give out constant 5 volt through this charging cable. Let me turn it around. Okay, let me just connect this charging cable to the Android phone, and you can see this, it has started charging. Let me do it once again. Disconnected the cable, connected it to the Android phone, and it has started charging. So this is how the whole setup looks like, and the USB solar charger is able to charge our phone. However, this is a very low power charger and is able to deliver only 2.5 watt of power. If you like the video, please hit the like button and click on subscribe.